Well, thank you all and welcome to my fourth project here in Toastmasters. And what I'm going to speak today to all of you, what I'm going to try to show you and share my experience, is about real food. Real food is a concept that has been changing a lot during our years. All the marketing companies and all the food companies have been growing stronger, and they have developed a quite big strategy in order for consumers to change the concept that regularly real food are. As for today, most of the people think something like real food could look like. Real food can be some donuts, can be some fried food, can be some hamburgers. Well, this actually is not real food, not even close. This is like all the products that they have been bringing the companies to consumers, and it's something quite far away from what the real food looks like. What I point out here in this presentation is that the three main groups that real food are, like generally food are composed of. Proteins are all the things that you can think of real of food, low-fat fish, and red meat, for example, those are type of food that has big amounts of proteins. Proteins are good for our bodies because they have to bring all the tissues and all the composition of our bodies, help recover and restore from exercise or day-to-day work. Second group of food that is one of the main groups is lipids. Lipids, there are two different type of lipids. The ones I brought today are vegetable lipids that are considered healthier than the regular ones, and are foods that help you store energy in order for your body when it is creating a stronger exercise or stronger functional capacities. It stores the energy in you in order to recover it and work with it. Last group that I wanted to show you is carbohydrates. That is also a group of food that brings energy to the body, and instead of saving it for later, what it does is a quick consumption energy. For example, if you want to do a quick exercise, you consume quite an amount of carbohydrates in order that you have the energy to accomplish that exercise. In this short introduction, I wanted to bring you these three groups because we have a big issue with why real food. What happens with all the food in our supermarkets, and what happens with all the food that we consume day to day? Real food is the closest thing of what food looks like on origin. We have to think about always the groups of food that food is divided in order to understand what the common mistakes that we do when we are trying to feed ourselves healthy with food and real food. One common mistake that I wanted to bring is turkey. Turkey is a food that is rich on proteins. We need those proteins in order to our body to work perfectly. And for example, this time we go to the supermarket, probably most of us buy these blisters of turkey that we all like and that are easier to storage, that are nice to eat, and they are quite quick to open and have for breakfast or for lunch. But something interesting of this type of food is that it's 55% turkey. So when sometimes you go and take some turkey from the supermarket, then you start reading the label and you find out that you are eating 55% of what you were thinking that you were eating before. Something quite easy to do to solve this kind of problem is, instead of going to the easy food, the food that has been marketingized to consumers, you can just take turkey and fry it from the meat or the butcher that is in the supermarket in order to get that rich food, that rich protein food. So this is a good example in the case of proteins of what supermarkets do in order to confuse consumers to think that they are eating healthy food. Another mistake I wanted to bring with the group of carbohydrates is with yogurt. Mostly all of you know this brand. It's a quite popular brand, Activia. Danone has been spending millions in thinking how to promote this kind of brand, and it's a brand that, as you can see, it has 19 grams per unit of sugar. Sugar is a carbohydrate that doesn't bring anything to the body. It's a carbohydrate that what we do is storage and don't use it for the purpose of the objective of carbohydrates. Marketing has made that this kind of products that are not really healthy and useful for the body look especially healthy and well seen by consumers. But for example, something that is quite easy to do in order to not consume this kind of products is do the same with natural yogurts. Those are yogurts that doesn't have any added sugar or anything, are nearly 100% milk, and you can sweeten that kind of product with fresh fruit or cinnamon, so that it has a better taste. With this, you can fight with this kind of products that doesn't bring you proper food to your body, so that you can work towards a more positive diet. The last mistake that I wanted to bring is with fats. Fats is quite common. Here you can see a cookies, that is something that we like a lot. Most of us would have eaten many times. Cookies are really rich on fats. It doesn't bring any value because are fats that doesn't work properly for the body. You have two types of fats. These are saturated fats and you have natural fats. The natural fats, you can find them in most of the fishes. This is an example of things that you can change. Instead of eating bad fats with sweet composition, you can find more natural fats. I wanted to show you the three main points in order to fight with these problems of our day-to-day diet, that are first, inform yourself and learn a bit about what you're eating. Always read what you are gonna buy, and finally eat it. But there's something you can't forget always, that is to enjoy what you eat, and we all love to have a pizza sometimes. Thank you.